I'd like now to introduce our student speaker, Kasumi Kanetaka. After graduating from high school in Japan, Kasumi came to UC Davis to study aerospace science and engineering. During her freshman year, Kasumi became a member of the Advanced Modeling Aeronautics team. As a section leader of the engine and landing gear unit, she helped build a radio-controlled airplane that the team used to compete in a national tournament. She also served as an undergraduate researcher for the Center of Human, Robotics, Vehicle Integration, and Performance Research Lab. Outside of engineering, Kasumi has played trombone in the Aggie Marching Banda and worked as a tutor in the Department of East Asian Languages and Cultures. She is also a member of the UC Davis Kendo Club, a Japanese martial art that involves fencing with bamboo swords. After graduation, Kasumi will attend law school at UC Davis. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our student speaker, Kasumi Kanetaka.
Thank you very much, faculty, professors, families, friends, and the class of 2017. And special thanks to my parents, who flew all the way from Osaka, Japan, to be here with me. Without you two, I could not have survived my undergraduate life. Thank you so, so, so much. Let me begin with a little story. When I was a child, I loved playing around, but didn't like cleaning up the stuff that I had used. I was hoping that all the toys would just go back to their original places so that I didn't have to clean them up. When I shared this with my mom as a joke, she laughed at me and said, according to the second law of thermodynamics, if you once mess around the room with toys, then the room never gets back to be clean unless there's an external work. So the toys would just stay there. Okay, I was 7 or 8 years old at that time, so I obviously didn't understand what she meant. After that, whenever I forgot to clean up my room, my mom used the term to remind me. No wonder I seriously believe that the second law of thermodynamics was a law of cleaning up rooms until I took thermodynamics during my junior year at UC Davis. I seriously did it. Applying skills from classes to real-world experiences is one of the lessons that we have learned at UC Davis. Being engineering students at UC Davis has given us various opportunities to have hands-on experiences to see how the concepts and theories that we learn in classes are used in the real world. I still remember the moment when the model airplane that AMAT, a model airplane making club, built, flew in the sky, crashed, but then flew again after our team spent all night rebuilding. Yay! Asking for help is another important skill. I am an only child, and I wasn't used to asking for help. But being a member of AMAT and the Aggie Marching Banda changed my mind about asking for help and working in groups. Now, I enjoy working with highly motivated people, and it has definitely been a positive experience for me. We will not be able to get here without each other's help and support. And most importantly, I love this community. At the beginning of my freshman year, I struggled a bit to be a part of any community. Since I was not a Japanese college student, I felt left out from my high school friends back in Japan when they talked about their college life. At the same time, because I didn't grow up in the US, I also felt left out when my American friends talked about their childhoods. It felt like one foot was in Asia while the other one was in North America. But gradually, I felt better because I became a member of the Davis community, a totally a new home that I began to belong to. At the same time, experiencing diverse cultures gives you a broader perspective. When I was in Germany for my technical internship at Dresden University of Technology, I thought it was interesting that the way kendo is totally different in Japan, the US, and Germany. Also, it is totally different seeing the US from other countries and different standpoints. By experiencing Japanese, American, and German cultures, I am happy to say that Davis is a place that I can always come home to. To my classmates, I would like to say, life is still long. There's still so much time ahead of you. It is never too late. We can do anything. Thanks to engineering, whose algorithms, knowledge, and skills can be applied to all other fields, we can go anywhere from here. Some of us will become engineers, others will be doctors. One can use logical reasoning to become a lawyer. In fact, I am going to UC Davis Law School after my undergraduate career to be a bridge between engineering and law. We've been running so hard for these past few years. And now, finally, commencement is here. Woo! Woo! Are you all tired? Do you want to stop? The Queen of Hearts in Through the Looking Glass says, it takes all the running you do to keep in the same place. If you want to get somewhere else, you must run at least twice as fast as that. We shouldn't stop running, but rather, let's speed up and fly into space. In space, an object with inertia travels in a straight line unless there is an external force. External force. External work. External. My mom was right. I used to add an external work to clean up my room, but now is the time to let ourselves go anywhere without adding any external work. All the memories we have shared as students at the UC Davis College of Engineering will deter us from giving up in the face of future difficulties. And the bonds that we built over these past years will motivate us to keep moving forward. The great end means an exciting beginning. With a full propellant called a diploma, we are now standing at the launch pad of our next journey. I wish everyone success in the future, and thank you very much for sharing the great times at UC Davis. Congratulations, class of 2017.